All right, hello and welcome to the Reptile Project. Winter is fast approaching. It is already fall and it is getting pretty cold out here. As you can see in my mountains here in the state of Utah, we are already starting to get some snow up into those mountains, and this can pose a few problems. As you may know, reptiles are ectothermic. This just means reptiles need extra help from external sources in order to maintain their body heat. Now, some reptiles can hibernate or brumate, like some of the red-eared sliders that are here in North America, or the desert tortoise here in Utah. Both of those animals can brumate during the winter if they need to, but they still need to make sure that their body temperatures don't get below freezing. And in order for them to do that, they burrow underground. Now, this here is Soup. Soup is a painted turtle, and painted turtles can hibernate during the winter, but here in Utah, it just gets far too cold. And there wasn't really anywhere that she could burrow into in order to stay warm enough. So we brought her in here. Now, you may recognize this enclosure as Thorn's enclosure, which is my Cayman lizard. Now, I have cohabitated a turtle and a Cayman lizard in the past, and it's also commonly done in zoos and aquariums. Now, Cayman lizards are famous for being able to cohabitate with lots of different other animals. So I've seen them cohabitated with iguanas, other Cayman lizards, turtles, and even fish. Now, thankfully, Thorn and Soup do get along famously. They do really well together. They don't bite, they don't nip, they don't have any sort of aggression. They mostly ignore each other for the most part. Thorn has his own area up high where he can spend a lot of time on the branch, and Soup here takes most of his time down on this platform here. And as you can see, Thorn honestly couldn't care less as to what Soup is doing. This isn't Thorn's first rodeo being housed with another animal. Thorn used to live with a painted turtle at one point, till eventually Thorn just got too big and the enclosure wasn't large enough for them to share it. Normally, cohabitation is a positive thing. With reptiles, it's pretty rare that you cohabitate animals, especially when you're talking about bearded dragons or ball pythons. I don't cohabitate any of those other animals. But every now and then, you can find an exception. And with the proper knowledge, as well as your own understanding of those animals' personality and how they live, you might be able to find a situation where cohabitation just might work. If you are just starting out with owning your own reptiles, I wouldn't ever really recommend cohabitating anything. Just try to keep everything as safe as you can. Keep everyone in their own enclosures. They will be happy for it. Now, when cohabitating both of these two species, I have to keep in mind of a couple of things. First, I need to remember is space. Is there enough space for both of these animals? Now, Thorn does have an area that he can climb in and get away from Soup if he needs to. Soup kind of gets this lower platform for the most part, and both of them do have heat sources, so both of them can stay warm no matter where they go. The main shared space they have is the 150-gallon stock tank that I do have in their enclosure. One of my worries would be if one of them gets sick. Since they live together, if one gets sick, most likely the other one will as well. And so I do have another tank that I could put Soup in should that problem arise. Overall, these two are doing fantastic and they do really, really well together. And I'm so happy that it has all worked out. That way, Soup can have a warm place to be during the winter. If you guys did like what you saw, make sure you subscribe and hit that like button for this video. If you have any questions, leave comments below. I am always willing to answer anything that you guys have. And that is everything that I have for you guys for today. So we'll see you next time.